I'm Ariana Vega, and I would like to welcome you to LakersNation.com. If you haven't had the chance to read all our stories, I'm about to bring you up to speed. The 2011-2012 NBA season schedule was released today. And while most of you know that the Lakers will be spending their Christmas battling Derrick Rose and the Chicago Bulls, what you might not know is that the next two games will be consecutive. Now, according to Daniel Burgi of LakersNation.com, the Lakers will be traveling to Sacramento to take on the Kings on December 26th and then headed back down to Staples to host the Utah Jazz on the 27th. Now, despite the shortened season, the Lakers will still play their all-time rivals, the Boston Celtics, twice, once in Beantown and another back here in LA where they won it all in 2009. Even though the Lakers season opener was against the Bulls, they will not be headed to the Windy City during the regular season. But there is a chance that the two teams will meet in the finals. And that means you Laker fans in Chi-Town will have to pay a hefty price to see the Black Mamba. In more news, sources say that the Lakers are looking to improve their outside game. So they invited free agent Jason Kapono to their practice facility yesterday. Kapono has spent the last two seasons in Philly with the 76ers, and even though he only averaged just about 6 points, his career percentage from three-point land is almost at 45%. This can be very beneficial for the Lakers since they are desperately in need of some long-range help. Now, yesterday, Laker legend Magic Johnson told ESPN that the Lakers will not win the NBA Finals. Matter of fact, he said that he does not believe that they are the best in the West. Instead, he said the Mavericks are his number one, and number two are the Thunder. Now, I don't know, Magic. You know I love you and all, but you can't forget that the Lakers dwell in the city of champions. And lastly, for all you college football lovers, USC's beloved quarterback, Matt Barkley, is not amongst the finalists for the Heisman Trophy. Now, critics say that Barkley was snubbed after a tremendous season, having passed for over 39 touchdowns, and he led the Trojans to a 10-2 record. And let's not forget how he embarrassed the Bruins with 6 touchdowns with a final score of 50-0. For now, Barkley is weighing out his options of making himself available for the NFL draft or returning as a Trojan for his final season. That will do it for us here at Lakers Nation. Make sure, if you haven't done so already, to subscribe to our YouTube page and follow us on our Twitter at Lakers Nation. And don't forget to follow me at Ariana Vega. For all your latest Laker news, right here on LakersNation.com.